Hello, friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to an episode that you guys requested, and a lot of you requested this episode, and that is, I got the advanced save game. As you can see, it's January 1st, 2018 in-game, which means we are almost half a year ahead of where the actual career game is right now. We have 100,000... Well, actually, we have 100 million krona. That is a lot of money. And in the next, 20 minutes or so, we're gonna go over every single boat or ship that we can buy. We're gonna buy that ship, and we're gonna put the max upgrades on it. We're gonna take it out to sea. I'm gonna show you guys a couple of crew animations, and so that way you can see all the ships and what you can get and what we can look forward to in the later portions of this game. So of course we start out here with a Borge, which is our smallest ship, and we're gonna have a quick look here what it says about the Borge. It's an old rusty boat with the sluggish controls that was given to you by your grandfather. The boat price is 10,000 krona. The boat length is 24 feet. Boat weight is 2.5 ton. Additional crew is none. Total quota per year is 110,000 kgs. Fuel tank of 150 liters. Engine power is 15. Max speed 7 knots. Required certificate is amateur. Max lines is 4. Max line length 500 hooks. Now, that said, let's go... let's go into the upgrades. So we have a store 1 upgrade, store 2, storage 2 upgrade, storage 3 upgrade is plus 3 tons, and then we can put a plus 5, plus 8 or plus 12 engine in there. There is one radar upgrade, and that's the 250 meter upgrade. There is a 1, 2, 3 searchlight upgrades. All of them can be equipped interchangeably. Here again, you can see them. Then we have a mast upgrade. I'm still not sure what the mast upgrade does, to be honest with you, and I haven't found anything that would tell me. But this is now a fully upgraded Björk. Of course, you can... You can repair the hull, and you can repaint it. You can change the name. That is it for upgrades on this one. Now let's go back one boat bigger, which is the Sjarken. Sjarken is a solid fishing boat with good sea characteristics. The large deck makes it suitable for fishing with long lights and nets. Now, it is either or. Either you fish with nets or you fish with long lines. Now keep in mind, this is net fishing. This is not trawling or trolling. This is net fishing. So you put your net into the water, you come back, you get it out of the water. We do know all about net, all about long line fishing by now. So this is the Sjarken. Obviously you can name it whatever you want, but we just call it the Sjarken class. It has one crew member capability, so we're gonna go to the town and we're gonna hire Rudy Hansen. He is now part of our crew, and well, you might be like, oh well, but I don't see anybody. Yep, that is okay. Now we're gonna go over the upgrades of this baby. Again, we can put an upgrade of up to additional... Well, plus 15, plus 1.5 ton, sorry, plus 4.5 ton, plus 9 ton, almost 9 ton more. And then we can put an additional, that's 15, plus 30, plus 50, additional 50 horse. Radar upgrade to 100 and, or 250 or 500 meter radar. Then cutting, the gutting is done manually on this one. And we're gonna upgrade it, or we're gonna interchange it to a net hauler at this point. Searchlight upgrades are the same that we had for the Borg. We have this one, or this one. And that's it. Let's take her out to sea and see how well she handles. Now, you don't see anything of the crew so far, but that will change if I go here to crew and put him on net hauling or hand gutting. If I go to net hauling, then you will see him come out here out of this little door. And he goes here and he will stay here on his post. But you won't have him to rest as much as possible while he's not working. We're gonna put him back. Or cooking, he should go to this table here, actually. Which he does. Or hand gutting is the same table, but without the... without the animation, and then repair is again back here inside this little... I don't even know. So... let's just, for the sake of the argument, haul one load or one haul with fish. And for that, to that extent, I'm gonna activate our radar. I'm gonna be fast traveling down here. And we're gonna go into this direction. Net hauling here, my buddy. We're gonna turn our sonar on. And we're gonna look for fish. And once we see an appropriate amount of fish, we're gonna drop our net. I'm gonna fast forward time and we're gonna bring the fish in just to show you guys how big of a haul that could be with one net. Now, I do believe that those are 75 meter nets. No, not yet. Nah, here we go. Set the gear. Yes, it's a 75 meter net. Now you want to keep this as much in the middle as possible. So we brought our net out and we're just gonna hang out here. Now while we are hanging out here, I'm gonna switch to the inside cam and we have a look at the inside of the Zarkon. See, we can manage the crew from here. We can tell them, hey, buddy, get net hauling. Hey, buddy, hand cutting. Or whatever. Whatever we want him to do. Now, unfortunately, this is as much as you can do here. You can't go underneath deck. You can't go in here either. So we're just gonna have to sit here. Of course, what you can do is you can drive from here, which is nice. But I will now skip time. And back here at port, we are going back out. We are going back out to have a look at our net that we set. But we are going to go back out with the Wiebke Catherine. Wiebke Catherine, spacious and comfortable 15 meter boat with a quota worthy of its size, suitable for longline and net fishing. The price is 1.95 million krona. The length is 34 feet. The weight is 90 ton. Max additional crew is 3 on this one. The total quota per year is worthy 700,000 kgs. Fuel tank of 9,500 liters. The max speed is 11.5 knots. You need the senior certificate for it. Max lines on board is 20 and the max line length is 10,000 hooks. That is a lot of fish. So we are going to look and we're gonna... oh, right. I didn't buy this one. Silly me. So let's buy the Wiebke Catherine. Back in town. And now we are going ahead and upgrade her. Now here we have a 3,000, 6,000 and 10,000 kg storage upgrade. And we have a 175 horsepower upgrade on the engine. We have a 250 radar, a 500 and a 1000 meter radar. We have the options between the manual gutting table or a gutting machine, which in our case we should do. We have, again, either be a longline hauler or a net hauler. We're gonna equip it for net hauling because we have a net out there. And a freezer. Your crew members are able to freeze gutted fish, which prevents the fish from decreasing with time, which is really nice. So we're gonna put that on it as well. And we are going to go out and grab that net that we had. You don't have any undamaged nets. Yes, I want to exit the port. Now, of course, if the net is gone that I set there earlier, then I'm going to be rather annoyed. No, it's not. That's good. So now we are going out to sea again. We're going to set sail for our net that we have out there. And listen to that engine. It is interesting, though. I think that this boat looks like somebody cut about three quarters of it off, or at least half of it. But I guess that's just how this particular hauler looks like. Now let's have a look on the inside. This is the bridge. Very, I want to say, luxurious almost feel to it. Now we do have now a crew of three, so two are going on the net hauling and one has to go on the machine gutting part. Let's have a look on the outside, because we should be able to see our crew going into position, which is the case. You can see them here on the lower deck. They are ready for action, and action they shall get, because we are driving out to the net that we put out. And that net made quite a dent into the population there already. Now I did notice that with the Wiebke Catherine, the sonar doesn't work for reasons only known to it. Oh wow, 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 wow! We are rolling. Hello, hello! What is going on here? I would be terrified right about now, screaming for my mommy, probably. Then again, I'm not a sailor. Brandy, you're a fine girl. What a good wife you would be. But my home, my love, and my lady is the sea. Okay, I am a little bit concerned about us picking up that net in this kind of weather. Wow. Now this is a big-ish boat, but the waves are just doing whatever they want, and I think this is not even that unrealistic, to be honest with you. This is probably not that unrealistic. I can't even see the buoys. Okay, I am a little bit concerned that we're not gonna be able to make this. You know what, honestly, I'm starting to think I am going to leave that where it is and we go back into port. Oh my goodness! Oh no! I'm not even making any headway anymore, I'm just... Wow! I guess this is what you deal with. Oh no, you don't want to get into that. Although, I mean, it's so wide that those... I have no authority at the moment whatsoever. I'm just getting tossed around by the waves like I'm a little Lego toy boat. And I guess that is not unrealistic. This is what you have to deal with. I mean, I love the fact that this is just happening, but it really doesn't have... Oh, wow. Did you see that? The waves just went right through the deck. Now, of course, let's be honest. There's only so much water simulation that you can do before even a NASA PC would cry for help. So I'm not too harsh there in my judgment, or I'm not too expecting too much. I mean, as it is, I think that... Whoa. Okay, I'm getting seasick. We are going back to port, and we're going to come back with a bigger ship. All right, after the Wiebke Katrin, we are now looking at the Lunar Bow. That is a different size of ship. The Lunar Bow is a traditional trawler and is built for pelagic trawling. The ship is rigged for fishing mackerel. The boat price is 4.9 million krona. The length overall is over the bow is 227 feet. The weight of this baby is 2.2 million kg. 7 additional crew. Quota per year is 12 million kilograms. The fuel tank holds a whopping 663,000 liters. Max and the engine power to start out with is 8,000. Maximum speed is 19.1, and you have to be a skipper to buy this one. So yes, we're gonna go ahead. Click yes if you would like to do the trawling tutorial in order to learn how the trawling mechanics work. I think we're gonna skip this and we're gonna... No, I'm not gonna skip it. We're gonna do this. So trawling is a significantly different method from fishing to longline and net fishing, which involves dragging and pulling a trawl or trawl back through the water behind the trawler. As a trawling can have a negative impact on marine environment, it is only legal more than 12 nautical miles from land. For this reason, you will need to head to the open water in the northwest if you wish to trawl. A mission waypoint has been set in the far northwest of the map. Navigate there now. You may use fast travel. But before we do this, we have to get a crew. Now, I am a little bit concerned that there is nobody left to hire. Okay, so we are having to set out with our crew of 3. That is a problem. Because... Oh, okay, there is one more. Phew! I was worried there. Now we can go fishing. And we got all kinds of seagulls with us. Oh, wait a second. Before we go, let's quickly see what we have in terms of upgrades. So we have an upgrade of 15 ton, 30 ton, and 45 ton. Of course, we're gonna buy that. Then we have the standard engine. Then we have plus 1,000 horse. Plus 2,000, plus 3,000. The radar upgrade is a maximum of 3,000 meters, which we're gonna throw on here. No, we're not gonna throw this on here because we have to buy... In its appearance, the radar updates are all the same. A Scanmar door sensor and control allows you to see the distance between trawl doors and gives you a small amount of control over their movement. Let's put that on. And then we have extra Scanmar catch sensor, indicates if the net is more than 20% full, sure. Indicates if the net is more than 40% full, 60% full, 80% full. Then we have the Scanmar trawl eye, detects the rate of fish mass entering the net, measures the height of the trawl opening, the height from the headline to the foot rope, and the bottom contact or clearance. And side thrusters. Yes, please give me both bow thrusters because, oh man, I was looking for those. So with that all installed, let's get out of here. Yeah, this is a different... Oh boy, this is a different beast. Um. How? Ah, here we go. So that's Z and C, or Z and C, how to make that work. Yeah, this is a little bit of a different beast. You would think that the bow thrusters actually help us to get sideways, but this doesn't seem to be the case. So you might be wondering, why are we back in port and whatever happened to crawling? Well, crawling is going to be an episode in itself, because I started the tutorial and I was 15 minutes in and there was still no end in sight. This is a very in-depth topic that would just simply blow the confines of this episode completely out of the water. So, with that said, back to the dock we go, and we're gonna buy the last ship, which is the Hermes. The Hermes is a modern freeze trawler used for bottom trawling. This ship is rigged for fishing, cod, pollock, haddock, and redfish. The boat length is 180 feet. The boat price is 9.9 million kroner. The boat weight is 1.572 million kgs. 7 additional crew, total quota is 10.8 million kgs, fuel tank of 500,000 liters, well, if it's nothing more. The engine power is 5,300 horsepower, max speed is 12.7, and you need, as well as for the Lunar Bow, you need the captain certificate. That is quite a boat. Ship. Not boat. That's in the ship class. So we're gonna buy it. And we will need at least 4 crew members, which we have. And now we're gonna go ahead. And we, very quickly look at the upgrades. We have a standard upgrade of up to 75 ton. And that costs only the small amount of 2.8 million. And then we can upgrade our engines at 2200 horsepower. We have a 5000 meter radar upgrade if we would like to do that. Then of course we have the whole scanners that we can have. The trawl eye detects the radar fish. Well, we went over this on the Lunar Bow. Improves maneuverability by adding side directed thrusters. Yeah, those, even though they are 500,000, I mean, honestly, at this point, when you spend this kind of money, you might as well just spend it all. For obvious reasons. Let's take her to sea and see how she handles. Oh, apparently we don't have a crew at the moment. Now we have a crew. Let's take her to sea and see how she handles. Gonna turn our side thrusters on. Or bow thrusters. No, I think they are normal side thrusters. They are not even bow thrusters. Because it pushes the whole ship to the side. Yep, that's far enough, thank you. And off we go. Quite impressive ship. Uh-oh. And this is the inside of said ship. The bridge. I was cutting it actually pretty close there to the port wall. Well, it handles like a big ship should handle. It's a slow and lumbering beast, but once it gets into motion... Oh, those seagulls, though. Of course they would follow us. Let's see if we can move around on said ship. We'll have a little sink. There's our drive for the crawling. And this is, again, where we can customize the scan bar, but this is exactly what I meant with the other one. Once I got into all this, I was like, okay, we're just not gonna bother about this episode, because that is a whole different story altogether. And as you can see, we can leave the bridge, and we can walk around on our ship, and that makes you appreciate the size of that, of this vessel. I'm not sure how much good we can do here. I don't think we can do any good, to be honest with you. Because our place is up here. Again, there is no interior of the ship. So let's close the door. And yeah, there you have it, guys. This is the last ship that we needed to look at. There's a little group to see here. The group proceeding. This is radar by the looks of it. We should maybe change our course. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. The biggest ship that you can currently, anyway, that you can currently get. I do hope you enjoyed the episode, and, well, you've seen all the ships now and what you can do, but as I said, I'm sorry, but the whole trawling thing is a whole episode in itself, I think, because there was just way too much going on to fit it all in this episode. So I do hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment if you feel inclined to do so. And until next time, this is the Northern Alex signing off. Thank you so much for watching, and God bless.